I have with me today our my executive command staff, Chief of Operations Christopher Goodley, Chief of Investigation Service Bureau Paul Noel, Chief of Management Service Bureau Lawrence Dupree, Chief of Professional Standards and Accountability Otha Sandifer, and one of our sergeants within our homicide division, Sergeant Rob Barrera. I want to thank you first and foremost, media, for coming on such a short notice to hear the update on such a horrific incident that occurred on yesterday. I want to express my prayers and condolences to the family of Mrs. Linda Frickley, who as well as on behalf of the mayor, our mayor has reached out to me to express the same. I've spoken to her husband, Mr. Ricky Frickley, this morning, just expressing, again, our condolences, our concerns, as well as giving updates to them as to the status of this investigation. So we are here today to announce the arrest of four individuals. I know this morning we mentioned there were three individuals arrested. The last individual we just recently arrested. Four individuals that were arrested for this horrific incident. Four juveniles, a 17-year-old male, a 16-year-old female, and two 15-year-old females in connection with this fatal carjacking that occurred on yesterday in the 300 block of North Scott. The four individuals that are in custody will be facing charges of second-degree murder for their roles in what we believe was a senseless, violent incident that led to the death of a 73-year-old citizen, Ms. Linda Frickley. This incident occurred approximately 1:35 p.m. We believe during the course of this armed carjacking, or during the course of this carjacking, Ms. Frickley was tangled within her seatbelt, which caused her arm to be severed from her body and dragged into the 300 block of North Pierce. I, on yesterday, in giving an update to the community, challenged the community to play an active role in us identifying these individuals that are responsible for this horrible incident. And the community did just that. So many of you decided not to allow this to be the norm, as I ask you not to do so. You decided to step up and say what it is that you saw or what you knew. We even received some information through Crime Stoppers. And because of this concerted effort and the hard work of the men and women of the New Orleans Police Department, and I hate to start calling bureaus or divisions, but I will try to do my best to acknowledge everyone, starting with the 1st District, where it occurred, 2nd District, 7th District, VCATE, VOWS, SOD, and most specifically, homicide. Worked throughout the night. Investigation Service Bureau detectives as well worked throughout the night with our citizens who called in and gave us as much information as they could possibly give us. More specifically, it was the parents. The parents of one 15-year-old female immediately called our investigators and turned their daughter in. Then the parents of the 17-year-old turned her son in, at which time we executed a search warrant at a location in the 3rd District. I want to thank the 3rd District as well, where we located the 17-year-old male and the 16-year-old female within that residence. And then within the last hour, 15-year-old female turned herself in. And I can't say this was an incredibly difficult decision on behalf of these parents. And I want to commend them for doing the right thing. And absolutely, we need more parenting like that. This reminds me of Mr. Alfred Groh, who turned his son in and made that difficult decision a couple of years ago. And in fact, upon seeing the breaking news this morning, Mr. Groh called me and asked me to express his prayers to the victim, Ms. Frickley's family, but also to the parents, because he understands how difficult it is to have to turn in your child for something that they know this is not how they raised a child to be. And it's very painful, and he is still going through that process. And he wishes this on no one. So he wanted to make sure that I let everyone know that he is praying for everyone that is involved in this. So I want to thank you also, the media, for, you know, it's very last minute on last night when we obtained the video, and each of you were able to take that video and immediately place it, release it out to the public. And in doing so, we immediately begin to receive feedback. So again, four individuals are in custody, all of which are juveniles, and all of this occurred within 24 hours of the incident. So with that being said, as I've always said, it does in fact take a village to ensure the safety of our city. And every facet of our community has played its part, from the criminal justice system, to the parents, to the community, to you, the media also. So thank you all for getting us to this point. But we should not stop. We shall not stop. This should happen every time we have an unfortunate death. We are never happy to ever lose any of our loved ones in this city. But should that happen, the same efforts, and I can tell you from the police department standpoint, we have the same efforts every time we have a case. Everything that we saw over the last 24 hours is the same thing that we do every time. But it will require the feedback, the communication, the information for us to run with it. And I'm asking you, the citizens of New Orleans, to continue to move in that direction so we can ensure the safety of our city. With that being said, Gary, I'll answer any questions that I may be able to answer.
26. In many of these crimes, perpetrators are also tied to other crimes in the community. Are these four currently tied to anything else, or did anything else happen as a result of them having this race?
Right now, we do not have anything that lead us to believe that that vehicle was used in anything else, and we are looking to see if they were involved in any other crimes. That is a part of our protocol. When an arrest is made, have these individuals been involved in any other crimes? Right now, we don't have anything to report with that regard.
So just to make sure, because we're being told that they may have been involved in had previous arrest records, are you able to elaborate on any of their prior arrests?
Well, the arrest records, what they have been arrested for in the past had nothing to do with the incident on yesterday. I will not go into the specifics of their arrest records, but a couple of them have been arrested before.
Do you want the DA to see them charged as adults?
So that is a conversation that my team will have with the district attorney's office. I would say absolutely. I would say absolutely. I encourage, I will ask that they be charged as adults. I mean, look at the nature of the crime. Look at what we're facing, being brazenness, broad daylight, with no regards to this woman hanging from the vehicle. So, I mean, I think at some point in time, we have to step up and say we're going to hold individuals accountable. So there's no doubt in my mind we're going to come to some sort of place in which these individuals will be held accountable to our standards. Next. I believe so. At this point in time, it is our understanding that he was the driver at this point in time.
Is there any relationship between the 17-year-old, the 16-year-old, any of the juveniles involved?
That is still under investigation at this point in time. Again, we located the 17-year-old and the 16-year-old at the same residence, but the nature of their relationship is still under investigation.
Chief, did they say anything about the motive at all, or is it the usual go out, joyride, commit other crimes, and then dump the car and move to another car?
We have not gotten to that point yet as to the motive of this, but I mean, nevertheless, I mean, I think it was within a couple of hours of the vehicle was located, and we just ran with it from there. But the motive is still under investigation. So, again, all this transpired. We're not even at the 24-hour mark yet with regards to when the incident actually occurred, and we have a lot of stones that need to be unturned. So, again, if anybody has any information that may help us to further this investigation, please, by all means, bring it to our attention.
Yeah. I was going to say a couple more things. Parents, were there emotions involved, any remorse, or what were their turning in a child such a horrific crime?
You know, to have a parent, I mean, within an hour after the first video release, we had parents at our police station. So, I mean, of course, there are a lot of emotions. And I wouldn't even begin to want to wonder what those emotions are like. You know, I've developed a relationship with Mr. Groh, and I know what he expresses to me. And it is very, very difficult, you know, and to continue to have to deal with your child from that distance, it is hard. So, I mean, yes, there are a lot of emotions to answer your question.
Two more quick things. How rare or how uncommon is it to have girls involved in such a violence?
So I think about a year or so ago, we mentioned this, that we are starting to see more females involved in a lot of our crimes. You know, I even go back a couple of years ago, we were talking about the rash of auto burglars going towards the latter part of 2019 into 2020. We were speaking to females being involved in this. So we are starting to see that. That is very concerning. Just had a female arrested for discharging a weapon and killing someone on Bourbon Street. So it is very concerning. But nevertheless, I think there's a behavior. It's not necessarily about a gender thing. There's a certain culture or behavior that we must address.
Okay, we've got time for a couple more.
Mm-hmm. So that's the point we're trying to find out now. I mean, some schools release early. When you talk about the communication aspect of it all, I remember seeing one individual spoke about how the police was there and they were looking for EMS, I guess because of the proximity in which we were coming from. But I don't have the exact time on that. I was never made aware by anyone that there was some sort of delay. But I can tell you, when you're dealing with a situation such as what they were facing on yesterday, and you saw the emotions from many of the residents within the area, a second or 30 seconds can be a lifetime.
Do you, or did any of the teens that had prior criminal charges serve any time for whatever they may have done prior to this? And in this instance, a lot of people have been saying they're frustrated with the way violent youth
So I cannot answer the question as to time, if they spent any time or were held accountable with regards to time for any previous arrests. We at the department just going to continue what we have been doing, which is make the arrest. Everything else is pretty much, you know, beyond us, but we're there to support every step of the way. Again, I am not an advocate for incarceration, but some individuals need to be locked up. They need to be in jail. And I don't care what the age is. When you commit a crime like this, absolutely, they need to be locked up. I believe the young lady behind you was trying to ask a question and been trying to for quite some time. No worries. Nothing new right now. Nothing new as of right now. Again, we've been running with this, and of course, you know, we have our eggs all over the place, so we're really trying to see what we can do, but nothing new on that right now, no ma'am.
All right, we have time for one more. I'm going to give it to Meg.
Any possible ties to the escapee from Bridge City?
No, none that we know of, no ma'am.
Did the driver know the lady was still attached?
Don't know. I mean, we still, again, that's a part of interviewing and identifying that motive and all of that, so no.
All right, the last question from Natasha.
Mm-hmm. Do you believe that they were a group operating together, that this wasn't just a mishap, that they were all together and committed this?
Not to, you know, I don't know. I can't answer that question until we are able to determine if they are responsible for other crimes. What I can say, though, you know, again, we have those loose-knit groups just yesterday evening. We had approximately 3 or 4 armed robberies or carjackings from Sunday afternoon leading into Monday morning. Of course, the first question in our mind was, were they connected to this homicide? And right now we have no reason to believe so, but what we do know is that 7th District was able to get behind one of the vehicles and have a pursuit on yesterday afternoon and arrested 3 individuals that we think are going to be responsible for those series of armed robberies, but we can't see that they are necessarily connected. But what I say all of that to say that they're loose-knit groups that, you know, I think kids being kids willing to engage in criminal activity, not caring are not willing to, not knowing the consequences or if they believe there are any consequences to their actions. So, again, we as a community stepped up on this one. We need to step up on all of these cases. And, again, we see something before it happens, say something. No matter how minute you may think it is, dial 911. Let us engage. Let us determine if it's something that needs further investigation. But even with that engagement of us encountering these individuals, it may prevent someone else from losing their life. So, again, thank you all for all that you have done to help us solve this. Do not let us as a community stop here. And I'm speaking to the community. Do not stop here. We need your support. We need your help in addressing these other crimes that we are investigating to hopefully prevent others from occurring.
Thank you very much.